Hi, it's Jeff from How They Ended It. Today we're going to be interviewing the head of Spirit Airlines, and we contacted him. His name is Edward, and I'm so happy to meet with the esteemed businessman who is so known for his great business decisions. So, Edward, nice to meet you.
You too.
Okay, so first question I want to ask, is Spirit Airlines cheap?
No, it's very expensive, in fact.
A lot of our viewers are wondering, how is Spirit Airlines stock?
It's gone off the charts, pun intended. You give
me mine. Another big question mark in the Spirit Airlines realm is, what about your marketing? You know, a lot of businesses have marketing on YouTube or social media, on TV. I go on the Super Bowl, there ain't no Spirit Airlines commercial or YouTube or social media. Like, I don't see any famous vloggers saying, hey, if you follow me, you get a free Spirit Airlines ticket. So what's really going on with the Spirit Airlines marketing?
Two things. One, that example is pretty dumb because they do so much money. Also, that's the marketing team's business, not mine. I'm not the marketing team. I'm only the man that runs the company. What do you expect from me? To run the goddamn company?
It may be winter here, but it's still summer where Spirit Airlines flies. From Newark, there's new service to Orlando.
So, Edward, are there ever fights on Spirit Airlines?
Never.
Point, a brawl breaks out outside of a Spirit Airlines gate.
Hey Edward, I have another question for you. What's your plane crash record under your leadership?
Little to none.
Oh, I find that hard to believe, as in many sources they say you're the single most responsible man for plane crashes.
I'm the second most.
Who's first?
Michael Bay.
Airlines plane spews parts after Detroit takeoff.
Patiently waiting for us to come home, to go outside, or to play with them. They wait.
Those passengers don't know it yet, but they are seconds away from experiencing the worst fear of every air traveler. Suddenly, the alarm sounds. The plane is going down, spiraling into the ocean.
So, Edward, if you can compare Spirit Airlines to one other thing, what would it be?
It would be Royal Caribbean Cruise Line. Like them, we take people from point A to point B, give them a fun, entertainment-food time with lots of entertainment and food that is just so good.
Carnival.
What?
Going on Spirit Airlines? The Motel 6 of the sky?
Edward, we are living through a pandemic, as you're aware.
No, I'm not aware.
Well, we are living through a pandemic. How is Spirit Airlines, the esteemed airlines, managing COVID safety?
We are following, the CDC guidelines. We're following those all the way.
I just deplaned my first Spirit flight since the coronavirus pandemic. And honestly, besides the wearing of masks, you could hardly tell that it was a global pandemic on that Spirit flight at all.
Overall, these were my takeaways from flying Spirit during coronavirus. There was no enforcement of mask wearing at the gate, and no enforced social distancing during boarding or deplaning. Spirit is not blocking middle seats in flight, and there seemed to be a relaxed approach to the enhanced safety protocol, like attendants pulling their masks down to give announcements.
I have another question, Edward. How does the public view Spirit Airlines?
They love it. It's like the golden corral of airlines. It's the family place to go when you want a good meal, or in this case, a flight with a good meal from point A to point goddamn B.
Edward, do your passengers behave?
Yes, they behave the whole flight, every day, every year, every century.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's see who was paying attention. Go ahead and point to where that oxygen mask is going to come from. That's awesome. Three of you are going to get oxygen. That's great. That's perfect. The rest of you, when you're done screaming, okay, I need you to let go of your neighbor and grab that mask. You're going to place it over your nose and mouth. You're going to look at each other and you're going to say, out loud. No, you're going to breathe normally. Normal breathing in an emergency. Who writes this stuff? You're going to breathe as normally as you possibly can. They want you to assist yourself first and then a child traveling with you. Ladies, listen to me. A child traveling with you. They come in many different shapes and sizes. Do you hear me? If you have more than one of these child traveling with you, assess your situation. Who's it gonna be? Well, you can't help everybody, so y'all are gonna have to decide. I mean, pick your favorite. You know you've got one. Probably don't wanna tell them. But children, if you did not do your homework last week, I don't think you're gonna get a mask. It's not a good thing. All right, we do not anticipate this flight turn into a cruise, folks. If we did, I wouldn't have worn this. I would have worn a bathing suit. All right, but if it happens, where's the life vest? Underneath the seat in front of you. Right, so whoever didn't get that mask, just give them a life vest. Maybe they'll be okay.